What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Critical Overlord here. In this video, I'm going to just be talking about Jason Blum and Blumhouse wanting to bring back the Scream franchise. So last year, I think this is when the first talk started about this idea. They even said they wanted to bring back I Know What You Did Last Summer, or do a reboot of I Know What You Did Last Summer. Recently, Jason Blum had an interview and he said a bit more. He said that's something they've looked into, but nothing's happening at the moment. That's not what I want to talk about. I want to talk about the idea of them bringing it back and what could potentially be done. If they did eventually get a hold of the Scream property, I would like them to do Scream 5 and just have that be a sequel to Scream 4. It doesn't have to be set a full 8 years later. Of course, you could always do that. It could be set like 1 or 2 years later, possibly 3, 5. It doesn't have to be the full 8 because it's been 8 years since Scream 4 came out. You don't have to do another large time gap like you have with Scream 3 and Scream 4. You don't have to do that. You could always just set this movie a few years later. I would like Scream 5 to bring back Neve Campbell, David Arquette, Courtney Cox. Wrap the series up. Don't do what you did with Halloween. Of course, that's always an option. I think that's what the reports make it seem like they want to do. But that's nothing. Nothing concrete has been given as to what they. All we know is that they have interest in getting more entries in that film franchise. They want to do Scream movies. That could be a plethora of things. That could be a Scream 5. That could be remaking the first movie. That could be ignoring some films and being a sequel to a certain movie. It could ignore Scream 4 and basically do its own thing and still be Scream 5, but it's ignoring Scream 4. I don't know. Something of that sort. I don't think remaking it would be anything to I don't think remaking it would be the best idea, because unlike the Halloween series, Scream is more consistent. It has a more consistent narrative being told in it. It's more consistent than a lot of the other horror franchises that came around the 70s and the 80s and whatnot. You have the same cast for the most part in each movie. You have the same writer for the most part for each movie. You have the same director for the most part with each movie. Just some things should be left untouched. And I even think they had the same musical composer for pretty much every sequel. I think Marco Beltrami composed all four sequels, if I'm not mistaken. If I am, please correct me. But Scream is definitely one of the more consistent horror franchises that will come out in the last decade or so. So if Blumhouse gets their hands on the property, I would like for them to do Scream 5, bring back Courtney Cox, Neve Campbell, David Arquette, set the movie a few years after Scream 4. Sydney Prescott is back in the turmoil again. She has another Ghostface killer chasing her down. We could explore a few more things that we didn't find out in the original trilogy, because if you recall, Scream 4 was supposed to be the beginning of a new trilogy. That, of course, did not happen, because once Wes Craven died in 2015, plans of doing anything else with the series were basically put on hold, and we haven't heard anything since. Sydney Prescott, or Neve Campbell, the actress who plays Sydney Prescott, she has gone on record saying that she doesn't think it could work without Wes on multiple occasions. David Arquette, who plays Dewey in the film, he has stated that he would be down to do a fifth movie if it ever got confirmed. So we know his involvement is something that he would like. We know this is something that David Arquette would like to be involved in. I think the tricky part is going to be convincing Neve Campbell to come back, convincing Kevin Williamson to come back, because Kevin Williamson, if I'm not mistaken, is the one who said that Craven's death is what affected anything further moving ahead with the series, because I don't think anyone wants to actually touch this series without his involvement, because he was such a crucial component to the series, because he directed all four films. And I think it's just more of a respect thing, not because you could always, I think they are well aware that they could continue without him, but it's more so a respect thing, because the series is mostly Scream and Nightmare on Elm Street are like his two most well-recognized film series. Wes Craven gets recognized the most for Nightmare on Elm Street and Scream, because the way he directed those movies is what made them what they were. And I feel like everyone involved with the movie feels that if they were to step away from that and do a movie without him, they would be shaming his legacy or showing disrespect to him. When really how you can look at it, because this is what David Arquette said, Scream 5 or whatever the movie is could just be a tipping of the hat, something that could be done in his memory to show that while you're not here with us, we still wanted to finish the series, and we hope that we did it the way you, and we hope we did it in a way that makes you proud of what you started, and now we have finished what you started all those years ago. I think Scream 5 should end the series. It shouldn't be a case where you even, Scream 6 could always happen, yes, because if you recall, Scream 3 was supposed to be the end-all be-all back in 2000. Scream 3 was supposed to end the series. If we do a Scream 5, I feel like that should be the last movie in the series. This doesn't need to be a case where we're bringing Ghostface back. It's time to have newer faces come into the horror genre. It's fine to have these revisitings every now and then. And I know Scream 5 and Scream 6 were supposed to come out a long time ago along with Scream 4. But if they do end up getting their hands on this property, I think the best thing to do would just do Scream 5 in the series. Bring back the original three. Do it right. Do something in respect to Wes Craven's legacy. Respect the narrative that was already being told. Don't try to retell anything. Just do something that would live up to what you know he would expect of the Scream franchise. Keep the self-awareness of the characters. Keep that cleverness. Bring back some terror, because Scream 4, I think that's what where Scream 4 was lacking. Scream 4 was lacking in the terror department. Nothing really too suspenseful there. I still think the scariest entry in the Scream franchise still to this day is the original one. The original film balanced horror, comedy, suspense, everything so well. And then Scream 2 did a fine job with it. Scream 3 was going off of the rails a bit. Scream 4 went off the rails a bit. So I think we need to get back to rounding the horror and the comedy and mixing them well together, because Scream at the end of the day is not a horror comedy series. It's a series that has comedic elements in it because of the situation the characters find themselves in. So I would like to see Scream 5 done in a way that will respect Wes Craven's legacy, brings back the original trio, get Kevin Williamson back to write the script and end the series right, send it off on a high note, have the film be in Wes Craven's memory, and just call it a day. Those are my thoughts on Blumhouse doing Scream movies. If you agree with this, or if you don't want to see any more Scream movies, let me know down in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already, subscribe and turn on post notifications so you never miss a video. In the description, I'll have links to all my social media accounts on my Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can message me there to let me know what movies, news, or reviews you would like me to cover in the future. With all that in mind, guys, I will see you in the next video.